In the syntax analysis phase, a compiler verifies whether or not the tokens generated by the lexical analyzer are grouped together, grouped according to the syntax rules of the language. This is done by a parser. Now, as we can see from the image below, the parser obtains a string of tokens from the lexical analyzer and verifies the string can be grammar for the source language. It detects and reports any error and produces a parse tree from which the intermediate code can be generated. So as we can see from the image below, the source language is fed to the lexical analyzer and then it finds out the tokens and sends it to the parser. The parser then forms a parse tree and send it to the rest of front end, and the rest of the process are given in the image below. Okay, so we move on to the next slide and we learn what is a parser. A parser is that phase of compiler which takes token string as input and with the help of existing grammar converts it to the corresponding parse tree. Parse tree can be also be known as syntax analyzer. Now we learn about the task types of parser, which is very well visualized in the image field below. Parser can be broadly divided into two parts, that is the top down parser and the bottom up parser. Top down parser can again be divided into recursive descent parser and LL1 parser, whereas bottom up parser is divided into LR parser, which is again subdivided into four groups. And the operator precedence parser is also a type of bottom up parser. Now we move on to the now we learn about bottom up parser. Bottom up parsing starts from the leaf node of a tree, that is the from the very bottom, and works its way upward direction till it reaches the root node, that is the top. Here we start from a sentence and then apply production rules in reverse manner in order to reach the start symbol. We can see from the diagram right that the process is very well defined, and this is how it works. Okay, now we learn about shift user reduce parsing. Shift user reduce parsing use two unique steps for bottom up parsing. The two steps are given in order, which we now we'll start with the shift step. The steep shift step refers to the advancement of the input pointer to the next input, which is called shift symbol. The symbol is pushed onto the stack, that is the symbol is added on the top of the stack, that is the push function. Then the shift symbol is treated as a single node of the parse tree. Now the next step is reduce step. When the parser finds a complete grammar rule that is on the right hand side and replaces it to the left hand side, it is known as reduce step. This occurs when the top of the stack contains a handle. To reduce, a pop function is performed, that is the top of the stack is removed and which pops off the handle, that is the handle is removed from the top, that is the pop, and replaces with the left hand side non-terminal symbol. Okay, so next we'll learn about the LR parser, which will
be LR parser. The LR parser is a non-recursive shift reduce bottom up parser. It uses a wide class of context free grammar, which makes it the most efficient syntax analyze technique. LR parsers are also known as LR of K parsers, where L stands for the left to right scanning of the input system and R stands for the construction of rightmost derivation in reverse, and the K denotes the number of look ahead symbols to make decisions. The types of LR parsers is given below. There are four types of LR parsers. The first one is the LR0, the second one is the SLR1, the third one is LALR1, and the fourth one is the TLR1. Next slide. Now look into the LR parser algorithm. Here the token is equals to next token, then repeat forever, which is the in the infinity loop, then S equals to top of the stack. Then if action is S and action of S and token is shift of SI, then push the token and push the SI, and the token is equals to next top token. Else if action of S and token equals to reduce of A and beta, then pop 2 into beta symbols, and then ace is top of the stack, and then push A and push go to ace comma A, and else if action of ace and token is equals to accept, then return, and the last is else is error. Next slide. Now come to the SLR 1 parsing. SLR 1 refers to simple LR parsing. It is same as LR 0 parsing. The only difference is in the parsing table. To construct SLR 1 parsing table, we use canonical collection of LR 0 items. In the SLR 1 parsing, we place the reduce move only in the follow-up left-hand side. There are various steps involved in the SLR 1 parsing. The first one is for the given input string, write a context-free grammar. Then check the ambiguity of the grammar, and then adding augment production in the given grammar. Then create a canonical collection of LR 0 items. Then draw a data flow diagram, and then construct the SLR parsing table.
Example, and the productions are S extends to E and E extends to E plus T or T and T extends to T star F or F and F extends to ID. Now the answer, we need to add the augmented productions and insert dot symbol at the first position for every production in G. And the productions are S dash extends to dot E and E extends to dot E plus T and E extends to dot T and T extends to dot T star F and T extends to dot F and F extends to dot ID. Now the coming to the next slide. Now the DFA, and there are 8 state and first state is I0 and the productions are S dash extends to dot E and E extends to dot E plus T and E extends to dot T and T extends to dot T star F and T extends to dot F and F extends to dot ID. Now we need to move the dot. So I0 go to the I1 state and by the E. So the productions are S dash extends to E dot and E extends to E dot plus T. Now the explanation. I0 state, add augmented production to the I0 state and compute the closure. So I0 equals to closure S dash extends to dot E and add all the productions starting with E into I not state because dot is followed by the non-terminal. So the I0 state begins S dash extends to dot E and E extends to dot E plus T and E extends to dot T. So add all the productions starting with T and F in modified I0 state because dot is followed by the non-terminal. So the I0 state becomes S dash extends to dot E and E extends to E dot E plus T and E extends to dot T and T extends to dot T star F and T extends to dot F and F extends to dot ID. Now coming to the next slide. Now I1 state, go to the I0 by E equals to closure S dash extends to E dot comma E extends to E dot plus T and I2 equals to go to I0 comma T equal to closure E extends to T dot T comma T dot extends to star F and I3 equals to go to I0 state comma F equals to closure T extends to F dot equals to T extends to F dot and I4 state go to the I0 state comma ID equals to closure F extends to ID dot equals to F dot extends to ID dot and IF go to the I1 state comma plus equals to closure E extends to E plus dot T. Add all the productions starting with T and F in I5 state because dot is followed by the non-terminal. So the I5 state becomes E extends to E plus dot T and T extends to dot T star F and T extends to dot F and F extends to R dot ID. So go to the I5 state by F equals to closure T extends to F dot equals to same as I3 means T extends to F dot and go to I5 comma ID equals to closure F extends to ID equals to same as I4 means F extends to ID dot. Add all the productions starting with F in I6 state because dot is followed by the non-terminal. So the I6 state begins I6 T extends to T star dot F and F extends to dot ID. Go to the I6 comma id equals to closer if extends to id dot equals to same as i4 means if extends to id dot, and i7 go to the i5 state comma e equals to closer extends to e plus t dot equals to e extends to e plus dot t dot id go to the i6 state comma f equals to closer t extends to t star f dot equals to t extends to. So i0 is the first state, so i0 is the i0. So
about the example of SLR1 table, in this slide here is the table of SLR1, and the explanation of the table is first e is equal to first e plus t union first t, then first t is equal to first t star f union first f, then first f is equal to id, first t is equal to id, first e is equal to id, then follow e is equal to first plus t union dollar is equal to plus comma dollar, then follow t is equal to first star f union first f is equal to star comma plus comma dollar, then follow f is equal to star comma plus comma dollar. Next slide please. Then in the following table, I1 contains the final item which drives s tends to e dot and follows s is equal to dollar, so action I1 comma dollar is equal to accept. Then I2 contains the final item which drives e tends to t dot and follow e is equal to plus comma dollar, so action I2 comma plus is equal to R2, and action I2 comma dollar is equal to R2. Then I3 contains the final item which drives t tends to f dot and follow t is equal to plus comma star comma dollar, so action I3 comma plus is equal to R4, and action I3 comma star is equal to R4, and action I3 comma dollar is equal to R4. After that, I4 contains the final item which drives f tends to id and follow f is equal to star plus comma star comma dollar, so action I4 comma plus is equal to R5, action I4 comma star is equal to R5, and action I4 comma dollar is equal to R5. After that, I7 contains the final item which drives e tends to e plus t dot and follow e is equal to plus comma dollar, so action I7 comma plus is equal to R1, and action I7 comma dollar is equal to R1. At last, I8 contains the final item which drives t tends to t star f dot and follow t is equal to plus comma star comma dollar, so action I8 comma plus is equal to R3, action I8 comma star is equal to R3, and action I8 comma dollar is equal to R3. Next slide please. Now we'll coming to the problems of SLR parser. Here the problem one is a canonical set of items is given below, where s tends to l, l, l greater than r, q tends to r, on input symbol less than the set has option a shift reduce conflict and a reduce conflict, option b a shift reduce conflict but not a reduce conflict, option c a reduce conflict but not a shift reduce conflict, and the last one is d neither a shift reduce not and nor a reduce conflict. The correct answer of the problem is option D, and the explanation is the question is asked with respect to the symbol less than which is not present in the given canonical set of items. Hence, it is neither a shift reduce conflict nor a reduce conflict on symbol less than. Hence, D is the correct option. But if the question would have asked with respect to the symbol greater than, then it would have been a shift reduce conflict. Next slide please. Now coming to the problem 2. Among simple LR, which is SLR, canonical LR and loop ahead LR, which of the following pairs identify the method that is very easy to implement and the method that is the most powerful in that order. Option A, SLR, LALR. Option B, canonical LR and LALR. Option C, SLR, canonical error, LR and option D, LALR and canonical LR. And the correct option is option C. And the explanation is, SLR parser is a type of LR parser with small parse table and a relatively simple parser generator algorithm. Here, canonical LR parser or LR1 parser is an LR K parser for K is equal to 1, that is with a single look-ahead terminal. It can handle the deterministic context-free languages. LALR parser or look-ahead LR parser is a simplified version.
What is the maximum number of reduced moves that can be taken by a bottom-up parser for a grammar with no epsilon and unit production, that is of type A tends to epsilon and A tends to A, to a parse string with n tokens? Option number A, n by 2, number B, n minus 1, number C, 2n minus 1, and number 4, D, 2n. The answer will be B. So now the explanation. Given in the question, a grammar with no epsilon and unique production, that is of type A tends to epsilon and A tends to A. To get maximum number of reduced moves, we should make sure that in each sentential from form only one terminal is reduced. Since there is no unit production, so last two tokens will take only one move. So to reduce input string of n tokens, first reduce n minus 2 tokens using n minus 2 reduced moves, and then reduce last two tokens using production, which has so total of n minus 2 plus 1 equals to n minus 1 reduced moves. Suppose the string is A, B, C, D, bracket n equals to 4. Next slide. Now here is the conclusion. Finer classifications of parser types exist in addition to the coarse subdivision in top-down and bottom-up parsing. Based on the analyzed grammar, better crawls can be carried out on web pages with the appropriate parser. Search engines will always aim to optimize this process of efficient website analysis to provide the user quick and informative search results.
Very good. If some of you can